This screencast is going to show you the basics of the Euler method and how we can solve the Euler method using Excel and MATLAB. The Euler method is used to solve equations of the form dy dt equals some function of those two variables, t and y. And what we're trying to do is determine y as a function of time. There are a couple key concepts when we talk about the Euler method. The first is that delta y over delta t is an estimate for the derivative dy dt. The second concept is that delta t, the time step that we're going to take, has to be small. As delta t gets small, this method becomes more accurate. We have to know that function on the right-hand side. And finally, we have to know an initial condition. Usually, time 0 is chosen to be a time of 0, but it doesn't necessarily have to. And then we have to know the function value. Let's start with dy dt is some function of t and y. We approximate dy dt as delta y over delta t. Delta y can be written y of I plus 1, and I represents iterations that we're going to take, minus yi. So that's the next step, the function value, minus the current value. Delta t is constant, so delta t is going to be something that we choose, and that's equal to the next time minus the current time. We can rewrite it as delta y equals delta t times the function at the current time step and function step. If we expand that delta y and bring over the yi, we can write it in this form, where yi plus 1 is the current function value plus the time step times the current function value. Let me show you this graphically. So the way this works, we must start with an initial condition, so that's this point here, t naught, y naught. We're going to choose a very small delta t, and the first step, using this formula on top here, is to calculate the first point besides the starting point. So y1 is equal to y naught, that's the current, plus delta t times the function value at our current combination of time and y. The next time is just equal to the current time plus delta t. And when we do that, we can calculate y1 and t1, and we can plot that. We're basically finding an estimate for that next function value y at the next time step. We can do this now for a second time step. Our second point, y2 is equal to y1 plus delta t times the function value now at t1, y1. That's our t2, y2. We do this for a third point, fourth point. We can keep on doing this, and essentially what we're doing is we're building this function y as a function of t. And again, we're doing this just based upon the fact we know an equation for the slope, dy dt, at any given time. The utility of the Euler method, if we zoom way into the function at any given time point and the next time point, we're estimating the slope as delta y over delta t, and as shown here, we're going to be calculating this value, because that value depends upon the current, so this is what we currently know. We're projecting the next value. We're assuming it's a triangle. We know the slope, because the slope we're estimating as delta y over delta t, and that's equal to the function that we have. So this technique gets very accurate as delta t gets smaller. If we take very, very small time steps, then each consecutive time step you're calculating a slightly different slope, and so you can sort of estimate the actual function knowing the derivative. So let's go through an example. We have dy dt is equal to 14t minus 3. We have our initial condition. We know that at time 0, our function value is equal to 5. If you've taken calculus, you can easily integrate this. In general, you're going to have a very complicated formula. That's the utility of the Euler method. And we might be asked something like, at what time t will the function value y be equal to 300? And we're going to use the Euler method. So I've written my function here, dy dt is equal to 14t minus 3. In the Euler method, we estimate dy dt as delta y over delta t. And that's equal to 14t minus 3. And you notice here that I've added this subscript I. So we want to calculate that at the current time value. Now if I expand this and solve for yi plus 1, we see that that's equal to yi plus our delta t. In This example, I'm just going to choose that to be 0.1 times 14 times ti minus 3. We've been given an initial condition, so at time 0, our function value is equal to 5. And if I write the first time step, y1 is equal to y0. y0, we know, because that's 5, plus our time step times 14 times our initial time, which is 0 minus 3. And knowing y0, our initial y, I can calculate the next y as 4.7. The next time step, y2, is equal to 4.54. So I can keep going, y3, y4, and so on, to build this function. And obviously, when we decrease our time step, this becomes more accurate. It does, consequently, lead to more computing time. I've got this set up in Excel. I've got my delta t, I've got my formula, I've got an initial condition. I'm just going to autofill the time step down to about 10 seconds or so. And now using the equation we just derived, I end up with this equation where I've got the delta t set up here. The time has to be the previous times, and copy that down. So now if I wanted to, I could plot this. I could compare to the actual solution. I've set up a column here of the actual values based upon our actual solution from calculus. And now I can put in an error, which is just the difference between the actual and our estimated using the Euler method. So you see that once I've calculated the error, it gets pretty big once our time step is really large. So if I wanted to, I can change this to a much smaller value, like 0.02. Having a smaller time step will lead to a decrease in error. So finally, I want to show you how to do this in MATLAB. So I've set up my simple equation as a function here. And keep in mind that this equation is the right-hand side, so dy dt is equal to 14t minus 3. I've also set up a function Euler. It's a function of a function, because we want to write it so we can put any function into Euler, and it will spit out the result. So I've got a function here, which is going to be something that the user puts into the arguments of Euler function. I've got y0, which is our initial y. I've got the time step that the user can choose, and I've got the final time. And create a vector here of time, y1, that's our first element of the y vector, which is just y0. For I equals 1 to length, I'm just putting in that equation. The next function value is equal to the current function value plus our time step times evaluating the function at our current time step. And then I'm plotting this and labeling it. I can type into the command window Euler at our equation 5, which is our initial function value. We're going to do a time step of 0.5 here, which is relatively small. And I've got a final time of 10. I can run this function. I can plot it. Along with that Euler plot, I'm going to plot the actual solution from 0 to 10. And you'll notice that the actual, which is in red here, is quite a bit higher than the blue one. I can reduce that error by increasing the time step. So now I've reduced the time step to 0.05. and replotted this, and you can see that our estimate using the Euler method is pretty much spot on to the actual solution. This is how you can solve simple equations using the Euler method. It can get a lot more complex than this.